Hello and good afternoon or good morning or good evening, depending on where you are. My name is Jürg Langhart. I'm technical sales in KISSsoft. And I would like to present you in this web demo features of KISSsoft software, especially for manufacturing. As an introduction, as you know, KISSsoft belongs to the Friesen family now since some years, and because of that, we have, of course, we have a close access to the know-how of manufacturing. On the other hand, also Gleason asks or requests us to do features in the KISSsoft software to assist the manufacturing process more closely. And these features now we want to look at now in this web demo. For your information, in the handouts on this webinar platform, there is a PowerPoint, and this is the same PowerPoint as we will now look at. So you can download it and you can follow it. And in case of any questions, you can ask me for any details. It is a collection of many features in many aspects of manufacturing. And the details are the followings. It is, let's say, one part is about tool and tool design. Then one part is involute gears, which is also in interest of for manufacturing. Then one part is dressing discs and the modifications. So dressing discs are used for the threaded wheel grinding, and it is of big interest then what kind of modifications can be introduced by the dressing discs, and whether the dressing discs maybe can be reused for any other gears. Also, one part is the collision check, which is available within KISSsoft. We did this for some of the manufacturing processes. Then a quite a long-term topic is grinding notches and the rating of grinding notches by FE. And last but not least, it is, let's say, the gear measuring tasks from tooth thickness up to measurement grid data. As an overview and as a repetition for many of the KISSsoft users, I just want to give the details about as a kind of a summary, also as an introduction. There are databases available in KISSsoft for hop cutters, shaper cutters, and resting discs. We also have a pre-selection of the tools by pressure angle, the module, or also the base circle pitch. And you also may know that when you design a new tool and you would like to send a request, you can do this by an email button in the KISSsoft software. This we added maybe 2 or 3 years ago. In KISSsoft, the graphics, they help to understand about any situations. This is especially of benefit for the manufacturing topics. We have tooth form, especially for single gears. We have meshing graphics for gear pairs. Then we have, especially then for manufacturing, the tool and gear. We can see various operating steps or manufacturing steps. There are 3D graphics available. This is nice to understand about, let's say, twist modifications. There are also some functionalities within the graphics. So for example, one functionality which I like to use also is the saving curves. So this helps comparing And typically I can do so for various tolerance conditions. Also, it is a measuring functionality is available in the graphics. This I also like to use, for example, to double check about backlash or about grinding stock. And also the center distance can be modified to simulate a double flank contact and to check whether there is maybe an interference in the roots when a double flank contact is existing. Also, as an introduction for you, there are messages and warnings existing. These are the three levels of errors, warnings, and information. And to be honest, when I used the KISSOFT for manufacturing, I started reading these messages much more. So maybe it is the same situation for you. Sometimes the messages, we just, let's say, kind of have a glance at it, but we don't really read. To be honest, for manufacturing topics, it's very helpful to read. Maybe there is a tool addendum is too large or any other. And so I started reading the messages much more when I go for manufacturing questions. And last but not least, the reports, they are detailed. As you know, typically we have all the tolerance conditions also for each of the diameter, whatever it is. I think this you will already know. So let me start with the application for tool design. So typically the tool design is a major part for manufacturing calculation. A typical first task is to recalculate the gear geometry. KISSOFT does a recalculation of the gear geometry by the tool simulation, by these three tools as tool types. Then we add the microgeometry, such as crowning, various types of crowning, various types of tip relief, and so on. And also these we actually include into a tool, and we simulate this together with the tool then finally. So one first task may be that you want to enter a gear data from a drawing. And to do this, it can be a bit of a challenge. And this is actually how this presentation and how these slides are now intended for. First of all, you can see here a representation in the corner about the gear, what we are looking at. So you can see now it's a spur gear, maybe in the industrial application. Then you can find a workflow. And the workflow is supposed to help you for this same type of application. So in this workflow, I wanted to give you some guidance. If you need to enter, if you want to enter a gear from a drawing, then you should start with basic data, then go into the tab tolerances and enter about the tooth thickness values or the tooth thickness allowances, and then only go back to reference profile to enter then the grinding allowance or protuberance and so on. So this is a workflow what you can use to do this kind of tasks. And especially I want to highlight here, when you have a gear as a drawing, they may have a tolerances with saying zero and minus. So, and entering a tolerance with zero and minus allowance means that the diameter which you have in a drawing is not a nominal or a theoretical diameter. It is a diameter including the tolerance condition of, say, maximum And then Keysoft has a number of conversion buttons, which let you enter the diameter not only as a theoretical, but also then with a given tolerance condition already. So, and these conversions, I also want to make you aware again, maybe on these conversion buttons. These conversions, they are a great assistance in the Keysoft software to add or to enter the data as quick as possible. Again, there are some samples given here for conversions. One typical sample may be that a profile shift is not entered or not available, maybe as a number, but you have various types of two-thickness data given. So also this is a possible conversion, what you can do then in Keysoft. Or also, let's say for entering the manufacturing profile shift, you can go via the two-thickness values from the gears, and the software will then recalculate the two-thickness allowances and then also then the manufactured root diameter out of that. Let us have a look about the hop cutters. First, hop cutters, they are defined by addendum, dedendum. They can include protuberance. They can include also a ramp angle, what will create finally a gear tip camfer. It can include a full tip radius or any radius at the tip, and it can have a modified tool thickness so that you can simply type in the number what you have into Keysoft user interface and to input then the tool data as quick as possible. So we have now a first sample what we want to look at. You can find in the presentation or in the slides, you can find always then, or in the most of the slides, there is an example file given from Keysoft what is described on this slide. And now I want to switch to the Keysoft software to make you aware of what I mean. In the Keysoft software, there are in this window there are many samples given by the company Keysoft, and you can find now the sample 04 spur, and the topic is grinding notch, and you can find the same sample then as it is in the PowerPoint, and then you can check about these details. So about these details and how to do the handling given by this guidance. So I want to start with an hobbing of an industrial gear, for example, without protuberance tool. Then you will have, if you do a grinding, you will have then a grinding notch. And in Keysoft, typically you want to check about the form diameter and the form diameter, and in the same you can enter an active the start of active profile, the diameter, and you can check on the margin between active profile and grinding notch. When you decide to have a protuberance on the tool, then the situation is different. You will avoid to have the grinding notch. But of course, you want to check then typically on where is this form diameter, and so that you don't lose too much of the active involute, or actually of the involute. And again, you will enter then in KISSOFT the start of active profile from the gear pair calculation, and you can check then on the margin between the active profile and the root form diameter. As a next sample, I have listed here a typical automotive application. This is in the file single gear 06 available. And here I wanted to show that the protuberance, it's a quite a comfortable feature in KISSOFT implemented. If you apply a protuberance and you want to have the largest possible radius on the tool tip, which will also create then the largest possible root radius on the gear. And you can calculate this by one click also in the conversion field within KISSOFT. And this is quite a comfortable feature because you get some space because of protuberance, but there is no iteration needed then to find the maximum possible tooltip radius to have the maximum root radius on the gear. Another request can be to have a topping tool. A topping tool is applied when a best runout quality is to be achieved, because a topping tool actually will cut with the tool root, it will cut the gear tip, as you can see here. So, and in KISSOFT, it's a quite an easy handling. The topping tool can be activated by the checkbox. You can simply click on it, and then you can check also then about the diameter, the tip diameter of the blank and of its tolerances, so that you can avoid a too large chip thickness at the root of the tool. The next application is to have an hub with a semi-topping functionality. A semi-topping functionality we understand as a gear tip camfer, and it is possible when hobbing that this gear tip camfer is already then applied. And then after the final machining, there is some remaining camfer on the gear applied. So, and how to enter the height of this ramp angle on the tool? This is also possible by a nice conversion functionality in KISSOFT. We can have either the form diameter, the tip form diameter of the final machining or of the pre-machining. And in addition, we can have it for both of the tolerance conditions, minimum and maximum, for both of final and of pre-machining. So this is actually a good assistance. You don't need to enter the tool data. You can enter the required gear data, and this will help you in the tool design. A next topic, and actually quite a frequent topic in automotive gears, is to apply a short pitch tool. Short pitch tool is the wording what we hear the most, actually. There are also quite many other names for it, but it means that the tool has a different normal module than the gear has. And of course, it has also, first of all, it has a different normal pressure angle. So, and how can we do this now within KISSOFT? In KISSOFT, we go into the tab Tools Form, and there we add one more operation. We named it here a short pitch hobbing, And then we enter the required pressure angle of the tool. And based on the equal base circle pitch, we can use a conversion functionality to convert then the module based on the pressure angle. This one I would like to show you because this is a good chance to show you the functionality of the tooth form tab. There is a frequent question, what can we do in the tooth form tab? And this is a good chance to explain you. When we go to the helical, to the sample 08, so now we have a short pitch tool applied. And now we can see in the tab tooth form, we now added various operations, and this is actually the big benefit of this tab tooth form. Tab tooth form is independent of the two operation steps defined in reference profile and manufacturing. In reference profile and manufacturing, there are one operation step each. Possible, it means a very frequent situation is a hobbing and a final machining by grinding. But it may happen that for any reason, you want to have more than two steps. And the tab tooth form is a tool, or let's say a tab, where you can define as many operation steps as you want. Here in this case, it is twice an hobbing step is applied. This may be applied very rarely, but for the purpose of demonstration of this tooth form functionality, I want to add so. By right click, you can actually then deactivate or activate. And so you can investigate in all of the operating steps as you ever want. Also, it's a feature that all these operating steps, they will be done in the sequence as they are listed here. And this also represents the real manufacturing process where you also have a gear and you cut off some material, and then for the next step there is again some material removed. Okay, and now in this case I want to show you how the short pitch tool was created. In here in the pressure angle I can enter a new number, and based on the same or on the equal base circle pitch, the module of the tool will be calculated. The problem what the manufacturer engineer has is that if there is a factor-based tool description, as we have here, we have a factor of the tool height, a tool addendum of 1.868. And if we change now the normal module of the tool, it means that the absolute length of the addendum will be modified. And therefore, in this information, it says that the factor needs to be adjusted to another value. And this can be overtaken by the user or by the manufacturer engineer to overtake the value and to keep the same tool addendum. So you see also here there are some assistance given, and again it is actually quite a powerful tool, this tooth form tab, and it lets you define as many steps as you want. We use it in KISSOP for many reasons. One is the plastic gears, which are actually out of involute, maybe, of involute shapes. Then we use it for non-involute or we use it for a definition of any numbers of manufacturing steps. Okay, I go now back to the presentation. The benefit of a short pitch tool actually is to have a larger involute, and it means a reduced root form diameter from that position to the new position. And this is the gain of involute, what you can see. You can do this, of course, graphically, as I did here, or of course, you will find all the numbers then also in the report. Let us continue with the shaper cutters. How is the shaper cutter defined in KISSoft? We have, in addition to the hop cutter, we need to enter the number of teeth and profile shift. Then we have the same parameters, addendum, dedendum, protuberance, then tip camfer or ramp and modified tool thickness, which are available for definition of shaper cutter. In addition, there are various shapes available for the tip, for the blade tip or the cutter tip. It is, first of all, it's a radius, but you can also have a full radius. Okay, both is in hop cutters available as well, but it's also the possibility to have camfer as an shape for the shaper cutter tooltip. What is to be considered when you apply a shaper cutter for manufacturing? It is to be considered that the number of teeth of the tool does influence the gear root rounding. Depending on the, and here you can see that if we apply two different shaper cutters with a different number of teeth, we can see a difference in the root rounding. And this is something what manufacturers, engineers, but maybe also design engineers may not be aware of. So it is to be checked carefully what difference is created by a different shaper cutter. Also quite a frequent topic in when using shaper cutter is to avoid interference between the tool and the internal gear because of maybe the tool is too small or too large when machining. As next, I would like to show you the rollout analysis in KISSoft. What is the topic of, or what is the target of a rollout analysis? It is to display and to compare the variance tolerance conditions between pre-manufacturing, you can see the blue lines, or final manufacturing, you can see the green lines. Also, it is of special interest how the root area is created, and if there is some uneven stock, maybe, is it a sufficient manufacturing stock or grinding stock applied in all the cases. Currently, in KISSoft, we do not consider the tolerance of a tool. This is planned to be implemented into the KISSoft software. But per today, we can consider the various tolerance conditions out of manufacturing process. It means minimum, maximum tolerance condition out of the tooth thickness allowances. As also said in the beginning, as a tool, it is a dressing disc, is available as a database and also to save and to recall these quite easily. For for a threaded wheel grinding, we will need the resting disk, and this is defined by the parameters, as we can see here, it's an addendum and dedendum, then also a modified tool thickness. But in addition, it is then the profile crowning and the tip relief, or actually the tip radius, which is then the shape of the dressing disc. And this creates then microgeometries such as so-called shortened profile crowning and tip relief. It can be linear or arc-like. We can see both of the samples here in the two graphics in the K chart. The first sample is an industrial gear, and the handling in Kissoft is so that for the current gear, what you design, or let's say what you need to calculate for manufacturing, for the current gear, the tip relief value is pre-calculated for all the dressing discs. So I have implemented many tools in the database, and for all of these tools, we can see the created tip relief. The tip relief value by the tip relief itself, and the value created by the crowning. And this gives a total number of relief. And I can check then which of these tools, and you can see it's actually a very small variation between the tools, yeah, which of these tools is the most suitable for my gear, what I need to manufacture. Finally, then in the profile diagram graphic, we can see the resulting modifications. Same we have for an automotive gear. So we can also, this is a quite typical application for threaded wheel grinding, to have a quick process for grinding. And again, we can check here on the pre-calculated numbers, and we can select the best one of it. Please be aware that the process also can be modified a little bit. So when a dressing of the threaded wheel worm will be done, there is a gap what can be modified by the user, and also then the achieved modification can be modified on that. So this helps you actually to check on whether the dressing disc can be used for various numbers of gears. The next topic I would like to look at is the collision check for power skiving and honing. For a manufacturer engineer, it is of course of a big interest that when doing power skiving, we can see it here in the 3D graph quite nicely, there is no collision between the tool and the shaft shoulder. Or it can also be that when this is applied for an internal gear, that the tool's shank will collide with the bore. So for power skiving, we do the checks on the internal gears. It can be a hub, or it can be a gear, internal gear itself. We do it for external gears. This can be for splines or for gears. We check on the collision for the tool's shank, and we check for the collision of the tool with the front face or the rear side. For honing, it is a bit more simplified. We check for external gear only, and therefore we check for the tool colliding with the front face or with the rear side. Let's have a look at the sample, and also with the KeySoft, in the KeySoft files, you can find the same sample. Let's say that this smaller gear is actually to be manufactured by Powerskiving. The potential point of collision is this one. Yeah, and the manufacturer engineer will then enter the groove width and the groove diameter, which represents this point. Also, he will give some of the tool, some tool parameters. And finally, this will be calculated within KeySoft, whether there is a collision or there is no collision. And please, you will see that KeySoft is quite careful in the wording. Yeah, so we say, typically we say apparently known, or it's probably possible. The calculation process is a bit simplified due to the reason that the manufacturer engineer will have not all the details maybe available, and in KeySoft there is not all the data of the machines available which are needed. So of course, and we want to also to state this clearly, a detailed analysis is always possible with the Gleason software. We have also added one sample, which is an hub, a Powerskiving of an internal hub, and you can find the same definitions of within the software to be done, and again then the result will be that it's either not possible or apparently possible or probably possible. Again, KeySoft wants to be on a safe side. And again, if you want to do a very detailed analysis going for the last last of the millimeters, then an analysis with Gleason software is possible. If we want to do an honing of the same gear, of this smaller gear, as a hard finishing process, then we will see that for the honing tool, and this is a different tool than the Powerskiving tool, that the collision area is actually the second, the surface or the plane of the second gear. And when honing, the tool may collide with this plane. And therefore, the groove width is to be considered in this case now, this gap between gear one and gear two. Also for honing, the honing process, there are some parameters to be entered, and also there is you can see a calculation of the oscillation hub and so on. And also this allows you to do an estimation of a possible collision within KeySoft. Okay, so now we will look at handling of non-involute gears. A typical application is a straight side flank, which is typically applied on park lock gears. And in KeySoft, it is both is possible. You can either define a straight flank in KeySoft by parameters, or you can import a DXF drawing. Then the tool profile for hob or shaper can be calculated within KeySoft. And out of that, and out of the difference or out of the comparison between the calculation and the simulation by the tool, out of the resulting gear profile, it can be decided whether the manufacturing process, by generating process, is feasible for this current year or not. And if it is possible to do it by generating process, then you can export the tool profile for tool manufacturing. The same is for a sprocket, for a chain wheel. We can see here within Kitsoft that we can import a DXF file, and we can calculate then the hobbing, cutter or reference profile. And it's the same situation as with the straight side flank. You can export then the tool out of Kitsoft and use it for manufacturing. Okay, as the next part, I would like to look at applications for noise and stress analysis. First, I want to start with FEM calculations. FEM calculations are typically used for rating of for root rounding areas, and then typically also for grinding notches. There are two types are available within Kitsoft. It is a 2D FEM and it's a 3D FEM. The 3D FEM allows to consider the line load, or it allows to apply the line load considering all the modifications of the gear flank, means crowning or helix angle modifications, and to consider then also misalignment of gears. So in many cases where you simply want to rate on a root stress comparison between the root area and the grinding notch, a 2D is sufficient. So, and you can find then a Kitsoft sample, and we need to have a gear pair because we need to have the line load from the counter gear to do the FEM calculation. And for various reasons, actually, it can be that a grinding notch is applied, and the task of the manufacturer engineer is then to check on the stress concentration introduced by the tool or the stress concentration introduced by the tool of hobbing, and actually which is expected to be higher than the root stress introduced by the grinding notch. The same you can actually apply for internal gears, and you can actually see the differences between the, for example, the tip radius versus a tool tip full radius and so on. There was one interesting case the customer was requesting us to do, and it worked very nicely within Kitsoft. We imported a tooth form by DXF, which was created by the power skiving and by the honing step. And based on this imported DXF tooth profiles, we created then a gear pair, and we did a rating by FEM. And so the customer could verify on his operation or manufacturing steps, and to make sure that the stresses in the root area are not too high because of the manufacturing process. The elliptic root rounding is also a possibility to reduce root stresses, and this is also mainly used for plastic gears. And the same, you can also then do a rating by FE to check about the benefit of the elliptic root rounding versus the trochoid root rounding area. Also, noise analysis is an important topic. And noise analysis, of course, is a big word. And we need to be precise. Of course, in KISSOFT, we calculate the evaluation parameters such as peak-to-peak transmission error or sound pressure level, which is created by one gear pair. If you want to analyze on systems, then and also the KISSOFT software or other software will be needed. What we entered in the release to KISSOFT 21 or 2021 was to create a variance of modifications. So it means that you can, for example, define a profile crowning and a lengthwise crowning and tip relief in a certain tolerance condition and call this as a maybe best of best condition. And then on the other hand, you can enter a profile crowning, lengthwise crowning and tip relief with the largest tolerances and call this the worst of worst condition. And in KISSOFT, you can then simply recall these variants, and you can very quickly then compare the noise excitation between two tolerance conditions. Also, it can be other purposes. Maybe if you want to compare various twist compensations, or maybe various dressing discs and so on. Now we will look at some samples which are related to manufacturing. One sample is the grinding twist, which is created by the by helix angle and by crowning. And in KISSOFT, we can simulate the created twist if it is not compensated or if it is partially compensated. We have two samples, one including twist, one without twist. And with the contact analysis, it is possible to check on the contact pattern. And we can clearly see that a twist-free manufacturing creates a contact pattern which is different than the contact pattern including twist. So, but in addition to the contact pattern, we can also check about the transmission error. And the transmission error in this case was actually quite impressive. We could see that a twist-free manufacturing creates a much lower transmission error than it is including the twist. I did not expect to have such large differences, and this is possible to be checked by the contact analysis only. Again, a typical analysis is to compare the tolerances. I explained this already before. And here we can see also then the the difference between best of best and worst of worst. Now, when we look at the analysis by the orders, which is quite some difference, but obviously still acceptable as this is the tolerance range given on the drawing, for example. One more application we added into KISSOFT is a simulation of waviness. When you look at your measurement results, you will find maybe in the profile direction, maybe in the lead direction, that there is a certain waviness created. And in KISSOFT, we can simulate the waviness not based on measurement, but just on a regular on a regular wave, what we apply as a modification or actually as a manufacturing error on the gear flank. And it is important to understand what is the effect of a certain waviness which is created. And if you look at the results, if we have no waviness, it means a very very smooth surface, or we have waviness in some microns size, maybe only, this will create maybe then or will excite a certain order of the transmission error, and this may create also then in the transmission, this may create disturbing frequency. So the simulation of waviness may help to in advance to simulate the possible frequency, which maybe then create a certain tone. In contrary to the simulation, we can also use real measured gear flank topologies in KISSsoft. And this is also a sample what is available within KISSsoft. And here you can see the measured topologies of the gear flanks and of the pinion and of the gear. And when now looking at the results, when I compare a nominal topology with a manufactured topology, I can find at a partial load of 20%, I can find quite an interesting difference. So it must not be always a 100% or a full load analysis. It can be also for partial load, where maybe from the testing or from test rig feedback, there is at a certain partial load is maybe an increased noise behavior. And with this tool, with the contact analysis, this helps you finding on the transmission error behavior or on the noise excitation between the manufacturer part and the nominal topology. Okay, so then as a next topic, it is a master gear calculation. This is possible in KISSsoft. To my understanding, master gear checking or a double flank checking is still applied, and it's a very productive way of gear inspection. And for this purpose, you will need to have the master gear and to make sure that the master gear will not have any interference with the production gear, but it is capable to check on the active flank of the production gear. And of course, you try to use the master gear for as many production gears as possible to have an easier handling in your inspection process. So now we want to look at some applications for measurements or inspection. What one actually quite simple task, but also still it's a benefit to have KISSsoft for that reason, is to calculate the measurement over balls and the diameters of the rolls or of the balls. And in KISSsoft, you can do this actually then for, first of all, for several machining steps. You can do it for final machining. You can see the roller now touching the flank of the final tooth profile, or you can do it for pre-machining, and you can see now the ball touching the flank of the pre-manufacturing step. Also, if you have high contact ratio gears with a very large depth, then the initial diameter or the the initial the size of the ball may lead to a situation that you cannot measure, then the rollers outside of the tip circle of the gear. And by the functionality within KISSSOFT, it's easy to calculate an minimum diameter which is needed to have the ball or rollers applied outside of the tip circle. Again, it is it's possible to create measuring data also for special tooth forms. We want to look at some samples. We can look at the sprockets again. So if you import a DXF graphic, then you can easily create the X and Y coordinates, or you can also create the normals or the normal vectors or the curvatures, which is for each of these points applied. Also, there is a direct interface between KISSSOFT software and the Gamma software, which is on the Gleason metrology machines applied. So it's by some clicks, you can actually export the gear macro geometry from KISSSOFT and then actually import into the Gleason gear metrology system. And as a last functionality, I want to mention on the measurement grid data. The measurement grid data you may need to measure then the topology of your manufactured gear and maybe then to do an analysis with contact analysis to find about the behavior of the gear under load. In KISSSOFT, we can create the measurement grid data for many gear types and also for many measuring machine formats. So it is Gleason, it is Zeiss, Klingelberg, and many more, which are supported from KISSSOFT side. And this will create the data set, which you can see here, X, Y, Z coordinates, also then the normals. And this can be then used for these measuring machines, and this will be needed for the tactile measurement for the probe to then to take the topological measurement. So with this slide, we had a look at the functionalities of KISSSOFT in the topic of manufacturing. I hope it was interesting for you. And also, we plan to implement some more features in the near future. Also, we, as usual, we like to have your feedback. If you miss maybe a functionality, if it is some functionalities which you would like to have in KISSSOFT, please send us an email to kisssoft.info@kisssoft.com. And now I would like to check on your questions. And maybe to look at some of your questions. But for time reasons, I have to be honest, it will not be possible to answer now in this session, at least not all of them. There are some questions about modules, which module is needed for a certain functionality. This is easier to explain by email, so I will answer these questions then by email. As a last point, I would like to make you aware of the homepage of KISSSOFT. In the homepage of KISSSOFT, we have a new section added, especially for these topics. You can find in product overview, there is KISSSOFT and then KISSSYS. And now very new, it's about manufacturing. And if you click here, so then you can find an overview of the most important functionalities as we looked at now. Again, these major topics, what KISSSOFT can be used for. And so you can find always then information about the features and functionalities. I want to remind you also that on the platform of the webinar, there is the PowerPoint, what we looked at, is available. Also a flyer with a description is available. And also I want to repeat that you can have a test version or KISSSOFT test version on any time to check on your questions in manufacturing and whether this can be handled by KISSSOFT. With this, I am on the end of this webinar. Again, I want to thank you for your attention and I wish you all the best for this pre-Christmas time and all the best for your family. Thank you very much for attending and have a nice day. Bye-bye.